Connected. Channel switched.
Good afternoon, good evening.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Hey.
That's going to take a while to get to that altitude.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Robert. Hi, Robert.
Oh,
nice. Yeah, it's interesting. The vertical speed it shows is just absolute vertical. You know, vertical speed. It's not actually the vario speed.
Okay.
Not anymore.
This is terrible, Richard. You can fly, but you can't hide.
There's a fly on my windscreen.
Yeah. No.
Well, on this map, this task, the wind is straight out of the north, so.
So do you have to have Condor installed in order to be a spectator, or can you do this from the outside? Okay.
Yeah, when you connect to the server, there's a little check mark that says connect in spectator mode instead of regular, and then it still asks you to pick a plane, which is funny, and then once you're in, it's spectator mode. You can, there's two, when it opens a separate window which has a list of all the pilots and some options you can change.
Okay, interesting. I have to check that out. Is it just me, but the letters of all the tags of the other planes, they look a lot bigger than I'm used to.
Yes, if we're on the forum, if everybody was like,
okay, oh, okay, so it's, yeah, not just, yeah, so it's not that I changed, unwillingly changed any of my display settings, yeah?
Yeah, no, it's, they did change it. They made them too big. Yeah,
okay. Well,
yes,
I'm going to the terminal here, to the cloud.
Okay. So when I got online, my system told me that my landscape Big Pyrenees is either not installed or corrupted, and I thought that can't be. I remember I installed it, and I realized that I was missing the link. You know, I have the scenery on a different drive, and I do a junction. So it took me 20 minutes to figure out how I did that. but I'm here.
Also, the classification list should be scrollable now.
Well, it fits on one page.
Yeah.
I think the way it works is every time you hit tab, it will cycle through pages.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's nice.
But I guess I installed it wrong. My landscape is all black again. Remember, Tim, the issue I had with Denmark? Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll try it, and but I guess I won't participate.
No, but you can install it, and then you can spectate, I guess.
Yep.
But don't. Yeah, maybe you shouldn't close the condo. You should just rejoin as a spectator.
Oh, okay.
Then you can try to install the landscape as you follow along.
Interesting.
Can you hear me now?
Cloud not working.
Looks like it's dying.
Oh, I see the window high up. Oh, wow.
I think it's just limited to the player you're looking at. So you can skip around into any plane anywhere, but you can't. I don't think you can just freely fly around the map. Are you running like full screen? Yeah, you need to alt tab. It opened up a separate window. Yeah, so you just click on the planes and it'll jump to them.
But you can also use the function keys, F7, F8, F2, F1.
I think so. It was about the spectator mode, wasn't it? Yeah, I saw it, but I haven't tried it.
Yeah, we were just talking about it. So.
Yeah, I was saying that, you know, you have to do your research. Ben was really good, wasn't he, honey? Tried.
Yeah.
So I think there's maybe a talent that one can develop, but... I remember when my son was backpacking in Australia, and I gave him a movie camera to take with him.
Yeah.
And he managed to do one movie where he was actually talking. And he was obviously a natural, but he's never done it since. Yeah. Yes. I saw it, yeah.
Yeah, of course. That's the benchmark for gliding commentary.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think, you know, if I could control the view and Richard could comment via TeamSpeak, although there is a small delay, it might be possible. And especially if Richard made a task for the Norwegian Virtual Gliding Championship, so he knows a little bit about the area.
Have to do another one from Leirin. We can hope. Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, it's really for the specially interested, isn't it? It's a small market.
Yeah, but it could be fun to try.
Oh, yeah, without doubt.
You can get some NASCAR commentators, since they're used to talking about people going left in circles constantly.
I never did understand NASCAR.
I like NASCAR when they do on there's some road courses that they drive on, like in, I think one in Mexico in particular, which yeah. I enjoyed. That was actually neat to watch them drive on, because since they don't have downforce or anything, it's just entirely just tires and traction and horsepower. So it's just, you know, it's like, you know, any of those other kind of sports like that. So it was like, I always thought that was fun to watch, but the big high speed ovals, no. The small ovals, I think, are fun to watch too, because they can hit each other without wrecking, so they actually drive aggressively, and yeah, they can actually drive really hard, and also the cars around, they don't have limiters on the engines or anything, because they can't go fast enough anyway, so I find the small ovals are cool. And also, if you're a spectator, you can actually see the whole thing. Those huge ones, it's like, what's the fun in that? Half the time, you keep the cars around like a mile away.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember when we did the European Championships in Vorgo in 92, and we tried a new thing with hang gliding, that we should try and make a circuit with like 4 points, 2 months and 2 on the other side or something, to try and keep it, to make it into a spectator sport. The idea was that hang gliding should be an Olympic sport eventually, but it didn't take off. Haha. Nobody liked it. I mean, that none of the pilots liked it. They wanted to fly distance.
I guess I should have came over here, Tim, instead of staying back trying to climb that thermal.
Yeah. No. there's only 16 kilometers to the next waypoint where you need to be below 2,000.
Yeah, I saw that. That's...
So it's almost full brakes after start.
Full speed, full brakes.
Yeah, and beware of flutter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking of going back and switching to the JS-118 just because it has a higher top speed.
Yeah, there I am. I couldn't find a thermal.
Okay, Stephen, you can still join as a spectator if you want to have a look.
How do you do that? Other than like going on your website, how do you do that?
You connect back up to the server, and then there'll be an option to spectate. There'll be a check mark, I think it's in the bottom left corner of the where you connect up to the server. There'll be a spectate button.
So I have to exit the flight and then like go back into the server, right?
Yes.
But do I understand correctly that even as a spectator, you cannot access the server after the lock on time is finished, is it?
Nope. You can access the server any time.
Oh, you can access any time. Okay.
Yep.
Interesting.
Good luck, Tim.
Thanks.
Yeah, good luck.
Good luck. and
Gary, you're going to have to say all that again. They completely broke up.
Say again?
It completely broke. Who just spoke? It completely broke up.
Yeah.
Congrats.
Thanks.
Congrats.
It's really funny to hear out these comments without being in the game yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Good luck, Tchin.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, gentlemen, I'm going to test the scenery. Looks okay to me the way I have it installed. Yeah. Anyway, I'll say goodbye, have a good flight, everyone, and maybe we see you tomorrow.
Good luck. Okay. Chris.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
User disconnected from your channel.
But I like the turn point visualization, at least now I can see the circle and the edge of it.
Yeah, that's very nice. When you tap J twice.
Congrats.
Congrats, John.
Thank you.
Yeah, congrats, John.
Yeah, I can't figure this spectator thing out because I don't see any buttons to push for spectator. So I'm just going to watch you on the web.
Are you running full screen? It opens in a separate window, so you might have to use like Alt Tab to switch to the other window to see where the buttons are.
Okay, I'm on VR, so
it doesn't work
on VR.
Yeah, I don't know. That may be a bit weird.
Yeah, okay, well, I can just, like, watch him on his website. So, you guys have a good flight.
Hi, well, have a good afternoon.
Cheers.
Before I go, maybe it doesn't work in VR too. It's like you know when you like download the flight afterwards, and you can try to fly it, right? And like you're supposed to be able to do ghosting. You think that works in VR, or that this works in just a regular screen?
What, you mean the spectator mode?
Not spectator, but like when you like after the contest, right? You're able to download the plans to fly it, right? Because I've done it a little bit before. But you're supposed to be able to like do like ghosting, where you have like I guess if I'm thinking of this right, it's supposed to be like have like say like you can get any pilot that's been in the competition.
Yes, you can go to that Condor Club and download people's tracks and load it into the flight, and they'll basically you'll see them flying around as they did, but that. Yeah, that works on VR. That's the same as a regular flight. You just add you basically have to download them in the right folder, and it'll pick them up. And you can insert you can turn them on when you fly.
Yeah, maybe I haven't been doing it right because I've downloaded that kind of stuff, but I haven't gotten the ghosting to work. It's always so hard with Condor. I don't know if maybe you, since you guys have done it for so many years, kind of stuff, it's easy for you, but it's like always seems to be hard for me to figure out.
I haven't actually used the ghost myself, so.
Yeah, okay. Well, I'll figure it out. All right, again, thanks a lot. Have a good flight.
Thanks. Have a nice day.
Yeah, like ghosts from online flights can be a little bit weird too, because the start time of the flight versus when you take off and you load it by yourself is weird different.
User disconnected from your channel.
Yeah, I was aiming for cloud, but I didn't catch it. I would have liked to get high, maybe catch a wave. No, exactly.
Is a penalty for cloud?
No. Nope.
Okay. I'm in a cloud, or was. You see the cloud just by the start? The wave is there.
I also have a little text below the connection icon in the top right corner.
Yep, S3.
Yeah. Okay. Not just me, though. No.
Don't know what that is.
User joined your channel.
I think it flies quite nicely, this ASW.
Yeah. It's 3.4 here, John.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, the cloud is head towards just start breaking up. Oh, that's the number of spectators, what it is.
Oh, right. How did you find that out?
I guess someone just left, and then it went down the tube. Oh,
okay.
Yep.
So what's the drill? Just full brakes straight down?
Yeah, it was helpful to turn the turn point helpers on, because I could actually see the circle then where the top of it was. I was able to clip it right, but yeah. It's a bit of a weird task there, but I guess.
Yeah.
Hello, guys. I'm back. Don't say anything bad about me.
Hi, Steven.
Yeah, I figured out a way that I could do it. Do you know a program called Big Screen? It's in VR. And, you can have, a big movie theater. So I'm watching you, Tim, on a big movie screen, a big movie theater screen.
Oh, wow, Steven. Sounds nice.
Congrats, Richard.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay.
Tim, you used up this thermal.
Yeah, I sucked the juice out of it. Sorry.
That's how these thermals seem to be. Every time I get to one, it dies just a few minutes afterwards. They don't last very long.
Thanks.
No good there either.
No. What was first Webon? 2000?
Yes, the top was 2000, yes. Congrats, Richard.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Yeah, maybe this one, Gil?
I'm thinking I'm going to take it no matter what. I don't need a lot to get up to the next turn point, just a little would help. You got scared?
Yeah, talk to me.
So it looks like you got a nice climb there, Tim, but it looks like it'll be a submarine by the time you get there.
Yeah, there's an option to go a little bit south to take the ridge direct to the east.
That's good.
Yo, tack.
Yeah, to look.
Yeah, to look good.
Okay, Katasta can sit there and blink all at once, but I do not want it going beeping at me. I need like, I had the volume turned down to 1 on it, and it was still too loud.
Okay, yeah.
I think I'm lost. This is not working.
Yeah, me and Tim both just kept on. We were picking at clouds over and over again until we finally found one that was good.
I mean, a dead end without a cloud and no lift.
Oh.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, it's frustrating enough in the game. I can't imagine in real life if you're doing a fire competition and getting that situation.
Yeah, really frustrating. And you have to go back the way you came and try and find the valley.
Yeah.
A ridge.
Rich is good, Gun?
Once I get to over there, I'll pick it up, but right now I'm... I'm already flying it. I just hit a little bit of flutter right there, so... Yeah, I'll kind of drift over that way a little bit.
Oh, that was the problem. I didn't put my air brakes in.
Oh.
No wonder I lost so much fun. Well, now it flies a lot better.
Oh.
That'd be a useful optional thing, right, Katasta? They have a little beeping alarm that lets you know your air brake.
Well, I think the thing is to have it on a slider rather than I've got it on once. And it's easy to forget. I've driven so many times.
Congrats, Tim.
Thanks.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Tak.
So, Tim, was this the ridge you were telling me about that you had the option to use?
Yeah. That worked out as planned.
Yeah, I can see that.
It should be a ridge all the way to the finish.
All right, John.
All right.
User disconnected from your channel.
Ooh, too fast.
I think I'm going to buy some kind of controller with a slider so I can have air brakes and trim.
So you're heading east, Tim, but is that ridge south-facing hill or mountain? Because the wind's coming out the north, right? So it must be deflecting, must be facing south, because that's how we would be deflecting, right? Hello, can you guys still hear me?
Yep.
So, do you hear my question, Tim? That ridge you're flying east, but that hill must be a south-facing hill because the wind's coming out the north, right?
Yeah, but the wind is from the north.
Yeah, but that's, yeah, so looking at your PDA, that means that it's facing south.
Yeah, the wind is facing south.
Yes, even I mean what you mean. I know what you mean. I have the opposite. But today, by the new glider, I have no Kotasa.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like John just passed you, Tim.
Well, with the handicapping, he's still doing a lot better than I am. Minimum altitude is 3,000 for this turn point.
For the next one?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's probably up the top of this mountain range, so it's probably not too. I mean, I'm at 2,300 right now, so yeah. Ugh, I'm getting sink actually. Must be them in the wrong. There's sink from the wave.
Oh, John, I can see you going down, 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 down.
Yeah. Quite some sink here.
Probably should have taken that thermal there.
Yeah, I think I will. If I can find it.
Oh, that's not good. That's a crummy thermal here.
Nice, Tim.
Yeah, thanks, Ethan.
Well, I really, really, really should have taken that thermal back there, because now I'm stuck down here.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, there's very little lift. There's lots of sink from the wave, I think. And there's no thermals in down here anymore, either.
And you can't get around the corner?
Well, I can't.
Get a more clean wind?
No. I am. I'm just saying I'm going to have to go way out of my way off course to get onto the north side of this thing.
Yeah. Is the risk getting better now, John?
Yeah, it is a little bit better now down here. Although I'm still 1,500 meters below the turn point. Yeah. Or my DDH is 1,500 below. There was a thermal here that conveniently, right as I got here, starts to break up. It's fine. That's good.
Oh, that's
good. Good.
I'm parked.
Where are you, Richard?
I don't know.
Well, release the handbrake, Richard.
Yeah. I've already dumped some water ballast. Just get over this ridge and then I can get to a cloud, I hope. Or sink.
Well, this doesn't look too promising, considering that a B-29 above me is not able to climb up to the turnpoint altitude.
Oh, no.
I'm 800 meters below the turn point.
one left. Bingo!
You made it?
Yeah. Well, what I've got, I'm getting lift from a cloud anyway. Don't speak too soon.
Well, I'm not going to fly to this cloud because there's no lift on this mountain to speak of.
Nope.
Okay.
And here's hoping this cloud is actually still going by the time I get there. Four and a half, maybe?
Oh, wow.
That's good. I got 2.5.
Five?
This is getting better as well. I can't seem to center it. It seems like it's only half a thermal. Is it the thermal or is it me?
I've been having a little bit of trouble too, these thermals. Maybe they're narrow. I didn't check the width of them.
I think I'll just go for your thermal, John, instead of trying to climb the ridge.
Yeah, right now I'm averaging 4.5. At least the wind's carrying me back towards the mountain, too.
Yeah, exactly. It's win-win. And also, I could use a few hundred meters more for the finish in the LS4.
Man, this cloud's starting to break up.
Oh, no.
Yep. That's how always are. It's been... It may still be worth coming out here instead of trying to climb up there.
Yeah, I'll try.
It's not a 3.5 up here.
correct.
Congrats. Oh!
I don't watch on the PDA, following blue guys and flying back. Back to the start.
Congrats, John.
That's... Is that thermal still working, Tim?
Yeah, a little bit. But I still need 200 meters.
So if I understand this right, you have to be a certain height to get that next turn?
Yep, 3,000 meters.
3,000. So I'll just go north to the next thermal and drift in.
Oh, I think when some guy is in Spectator, he connected and disconnected here on server.
Yeah, I haven't seen that. I don't know if they're...
I saw it now. Nicholas is watching.
in the finish altitude 15.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm looking at this going, I'm going to be really high when I finish.
On the second point, turn point, do we just have to touch this circle, or do we have to go around the...
Just touch.
Okay, thanks. I haven't seen one like that before.
Was it the Pac-Man turn point?
Yeah.
Congrats to him.
Thanks.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Congrats, Tim.
Oh, I spent too much time in the summer.
That's interesting. It doesn't actually show the bottom of the doesn't visualize the minimum altitude for the turn point.
Okay.
Yeah, it the blue goes all the way down to the ground, even though it's 1500.
Yeah. So you need to look at your PDA?
Yeah.
Yeah, it would be nice if the augmented reality followed the rules?
Yeah, the top does, but that's kind of weird that the bomb doesn't.
Okay.
Correct, Richard.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Congrats.
Congrats, John. Well done.
Thank you.
Congrats, John.
Hi, you.
How did you finish? Well done.
Yep, now just to climb all the way back down to the ground. Or to descend down, land. I'm going to switch over to Spectator, too, when I get down.
Yeah, it's only 3 points between you and number one.
Oh, wow. Well, I didn't even notice that.
And John, like the gladiators in the old Rome, you don't even care if you win or lose?
Well, I was just glad to catch a thermal to actually get to the top of that last turn point.